Do you have paper scraps like these when you made your album, so you have your leftover pattern papers or anything like that, and you want to convert those leftovers into a paper cake like this? If your answer is yes, then all you got to do is you need to watch this full video as I'll show the tutorial of this. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Kanika Jain this side from Handmade by Kanika, and today in this video I shall be making a paper cake using scrap papers from my stash. And I had been getting this question regularly on my Instagram DM that how to use the leftover paper, so I thought this would be a perfect video for Sawal Saturday. But before moving forward, make sure you hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification, as I have noticed that more than 50% of my viewers haven't subscribed to my channel. So if you are one of them, you should subscribe and turn on the bell notification. So let's get started. So these are the leftover papers from my Tinny Winnie's paper pack from Dress My Craft. This is the 12 by 12 size, and luckily I had same design paper, and here you can see I have this polka dot design. So I thought let me take only one design and start creating a paper cake. So I'll be taking a long strip of paper from this scratch and the square as well. So first of all, let's create the base. So for the base, here I have the 2.5 inch scalloped punch. So just in case if you don't have a scallop punch like this, all you can do is take your compass, create a circle of 2.5 inch, and you can simply cut it with your scissors, like something like this. So if you don't have scalloped circle punch, you can draw and fussy cut with the help of scissors. It's just that my work will be little handy, so I'm using this punch. And you can see that how quick it was to take out the punch. So this will be our base. Now what I have to do is I have to create the layer. So here I have this scratch cardstock with me, and using a 2-inch circle punch, I will be taking out a circle. And if you're wishing to buy these craft supplies, you can check out the description box, as the link of all these supplies is mentioned there. Now I'm taking one of these strips, and I'm making sure that while I cover this up, the circle gets fully covered with this long strip. So if you don't have a long strip, you can join two strips as well. So this strip measures 4.5 centimeters or approximately 1.8 inches, and this measures approximately 18 centimeters or approximately, you can say, 7 inches. I'm talking about the measurements into centimeters and inches both, so that it's easier for everyone to understand. So now I'm taking my ruler and marking onto 0.8 centimeters with my pencil on both the sides, and then I'll simply draw a straight line like this. And now what I have to do is I have grabbed my pair of scissors, and I'm simply making slits till the line. So you need to make sure that you're making smaller slits, so that while you're curving the paper and making it the round shape, it easily gets circular shape. So like this, I'll just complete. Now what I'm going to do is I'm grabbing my ruler and keeping it on the slit side and folding up the paper. So just in case you have your scoring board with you, you can score the lines, as it will ease our work. Now I'm taking up the circle, and here I have my original tacky glue, and I'm applying this. You can use any of your liquid adhesives which is available with you. I find this dries out fast, and it is a very nice glue, so I use this one. And now like this, I'll simply start placing over the strip of paper onto the circular piece. So like this, I'll be preparing the base of the paper cake. So today I am showing just one layered cake. Similarly, you can create your two layer or three layered cake as well. I find that this one layered cake fits in the explosion box very well. And if you're enjoying watching these kind of videos on my channel, then do hit the like button And if you have any of your craft related queries, you can comment down below and I shall try to answer in the next Sawal Saturday video. And if you want to see part 2 of how to use your scrap papers to create embellishments, be it embellishments for your albums or your cards, do comment below. I shall make a video for the next Saturday. So now to cover up the white card stock of 2 inches here, I have my 2 inch circle punch and I am punching out as per the pattern paper. I will be sticking it like this. And if you want to watch my previous videos of Sawal Saturday, you can simply hop onto the playlist and you can see a playlist which says Sawal Saturday. So for the next step, here I have my crochet lace border die from Dress My Craft, and onto a craft color cardstock I have die cut it. So I have used the craft sheet cardstock from Dress My Craft, and using my Sizzix Big Shot I have taken out 2 die cuts like this as I want on both the sides. So here you can see I've already applied the adhesive and I'm sticking it like this, and I have placed both of these making sure that they off center with each other so that it looks complete and beautiful. And if you want to know more about what projects or videos I'm coming up with, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Facebook as we share sneak peeks before posting the videos. So the link is in description box. And as well, we share a lot of tips and techniques on our social media handles. And if you are making something, getting inspired from our tutorial, make sure to tag us. So for the next step, what I'm going to do is I'm going to embellish it a little bit with the flower pearls and then later add it to the base like this. So for embellishing, what I'm going to do is here I have the Dress My Craft flower pearls in the shade of white. If you want to know more about the flower pearls, you can watch out our video number 67. So on the border, or you can see on the boundary of the paper cake, I am applying liquid adhesive. And then I am going to sprinkle the flower pearls like this. I am making sure that I do this step on my funnel tray so that it will be very easy for me to recollect those flower pearls. Make sure to tap off the extra flower pearls. Meanwhile, this is drying. What I'm going to do is I'm going to apply adhesive on the second side of this. So now for this step, you have 2 ways. Here I'm applying generous amount of adhesive and I'm making sure that the adhesive comes out so that I can place over the flower pearls on the base as well. And if you don't want to add flower pearls on the base, what you can do is make the slits and add a cardstock like how we did the 2 inch cardstock, and then stick it over to the base. So we can do the same like how we made the top part. And here you can see I have the slit, the joining part, so onto that I will be adding my embellishment. So here I have some of my mulberry flowers and I'm just sticking them so that I can hide the joint where I have the crochet border die and as well the circle ending so that it looks beautiful. And while embellishing it with flowers, it will enhance the beauty of the paper cake as well. Adding the layer of flowers to it now to embellish it more. Here I have the happy birthday set. This is the die set from Dress My Craft, and I'm taking up my Easy Cuts machine and I'm taking up the balloon die and I'm simply die cutting it on the same pattern paper sheet which is from the scratch, and here I have my ultimate die cleaning tool, which is a must have craft tool if you have a die cutting machine. And if you want to know more about this tool, you can watch out video number 77 and see how to use this product in multiple ways. So that's how the die cut looks like. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just folding up the string little bit and applying a good amount of adhesive and then placing it over like this, giving it a 3D look. And you need to make sure that you're holding this up, as we have used a liquid adhesive, or else for this step as well you can use hot glue gun, as it will dry up quickly and you can easily add this. So now I'm taking another balloon and I'm placing it over on the side of the first balloon, and now I will let them dry nicely. And then I'm taking up the third balloon and I'm adding the third balloon on a different height and between the two of them, so that it looks like I have cluster of balloons, and it will give a very nice three-dimensional look to the cake as well. So our cake is ready. I hope you enjoyed watching this tutorial. Do comment down below what you liked the most in this video and what you want to see next in the Sawal Saturday video. I hope to see you soon again with another video. Thanks for watching. Happy crafting!